be 100% honest with you guys, not only am I scared, full of my mind over here, this one actually concerns me. I think this might be getting a little bit out of hand. Today, mystery meat number 4. Jeez, I don't know what to do. Oh my God.
And this is today's mystery meat. I'll tell you one thing, not only does it not look like meat, it also does not feel like one. It is extremely spongy, but my meat dealer said that I have to give this one a try. And as I open up the bag, oof, the smell is powerful. And I say that not in a good way. But now to test your knowledge, I'm gonna be quiet and let you see every single edge of this mystery meat so that you can put it down in the comment section and let me know what it is. After seeing all of that, I hope you put in the comment section the right thing. But if you still have no idea what it is, let me give you a little bit more inputs. It feels extremely tough. At the same time, it's quite spongy. It also resembles some type of tough rubber. But if there's one thing that hits me really hard is the smell. It has a very unique smell and something that I've never experienced before. When you take a look at it in details, you can see that it looks like a rug. I mean, honestly, I'm even having doubts if this is actually edible. I have never seen anything like it. And honestly, I have no idea what to do with it. But the first thing we gotta do is to try to cook it. And for that, the most important thing is to season it. So I went ahead and threw in a little bit of salt, followed by freshly ground black pepper, a little bit of garlic powder, and for some color, a little bit of smoked paprika. The paprika is just there to give a little bit of color and not remind me of the smell. I'll tell you one thing, I am not excited about this meat. And if you guessed it right in the comment section, I'll be very impressed. As always, one of the most important things is to make sure that you season both sides. But as you can see, this meat doesn't even have a side. I mean, come on, take a look at this. But now that we got it fully seasoned, the only thing left to do is to put it in the bag, vacuum seal it, and get it ready for the water bath. Now, as you already know, I have no idea what I'm doing with this meat. But if there's one thing I really love is lomo saltado. That is a Peruvian style stir fry that I really enjoy. And I think if I throw this mystery meat in there, it should give a wonderful flavor to it. I mean, at least that's what I'm hoping for. And to make lomo saltado, I'm gonna be using all of these ingredients. And I'm talking about tomatoes, steak, garlic paste, ginger paste, green onions, red onions, and parsley. Now, one thing you gotta keep in mind with lomo saltado is that you do not want to cut your tomatoes too small. If not, they're just gonna become a sauce. And these are how thick I like mine. Now, for the steak, I chose this flap meat. I'm hoping that it's gonna give a wonderful flavor to the mystery meat and we're gonna actually forget what the mystery meat is. And as always, one of the important things with flat meat is to make sure you cut it against the grain. That way we're gonna get nice and tender strips. But even though I'm doing the lomo saltado, I have no idea if this is gonna taste good. And if there's one thing we all know that tastes amazing is deep fried. So after cooking the mystery meat sous vide, I'll be definitely making a little bit of deep fried to see how it's gonna taste. And I mean, come on, we all know that deep fried tastes amazing. So there's no way that that's gonna be bad. But hey, that's to be determined in a few minutes. And since mine are gonna look like chicken nuggets in the end, I'm actually gonna be doing a sauce for it. And for that, I made a simple sauce using a little bit of ketchup, followed by Dijon mustard, and finished that off with sriracha. Now mix it well and my sauce is done. Hopefully this is gonna be amazing and we are really gonna enjoy the mystery meat. Talking about that, the only thing left to do is to cook it. And for that, I'm gonna be throwing it in the water bath at 185 degrees Fahrenheit for a total of 24 hours. And honestly, I'm not excited about this one, but hey, we are sous vide everything. So we will cook every meat.
Have you guessed it yet? Do you know what this thing is? If you guessed it on the comment section and you guessed it right, you deserve an award because not only does it look like an alien species type of meat, it also feels, it feels weird, everybody. I'm telling you, I don't know what to expect. I don't know if it's gonna be good, bad, or ugly, but we're gonna find out together. As you already know, I cooked at 185 degrees Fahrenheit for 24 hours. It should be nice and tender, but again, I have no idea what to expect. It's ready, we are hungry, but I don't know what's gonna happen. Let's do it. Usually, you guys see me taking things out of the bag and tell you how wonderful it smells, everybody. It is the complete opposite today. Let me tell you something. Does not smell good. It has a very unpleasant smell. I don't know why. As you guys saw, it was very nice and clean. By the way, even though I didn't show on the video, I did clean it even more, quite a bit, with a little bit of salt and vinegar, and the smell still prevailed. So I don't know, I gotta do something really, 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 really good to, you know, enhance this flavor. As you guys already know, one of them I'm gonna be deep frying. So I'm hoping that if I deep fry it, at least whoever is gonna be trying it with me will try it versus just being put off by the smell. At the same time, making a stir fry should give an amazing, hopefully, taste to it. I have no idea, everybody. I honestly don't know. I know it doesn't look that good right now, but watch this. All right, everybody, here we have our beautiful feast today, Mama. Are you ready?
We have some calamari and we have, what is that?
Lomo saltado.
Lomo saltado, yeah, there you go.
Yes, that's like exactly it. What it is, huh?
Okay, that sounded suspicious.
All right, Mama Zing, as you can see, my calamari sous vide style is a little bit different. I wanted to do in strips instead of the round thing, you know what I mean?
Okay.
Why are you looking at me like you don't believe me?
Because you're sounding suspicious now.
Well, at the same time, we're gonna find out how it tastes. I'm actually very excited to find out how it's gonna taste because it was quite a process to make. You know, I've never made calamari sous vide, okay. So it's my first time. You ready?
Okay.
It's finger food, I guess, right? Go for it, Mama. You try it first. I wanna know what it tastes like. Here, we got salsita here.
Why are you not trying it with me?
No, I'm gonna, come on. You think I'm gonna do that? I'm not gonna do that to you, Mama. Of course I'm gonna try it together.
He's acting suspicious, smells, isn't he?
Very good. You ready for this, Mama?
Yep.
All right. Cheers, everybody.
Cheers. It's not calamari.
Nope, it's not calamari.
But it's chewy like it.
It's chewy like it.
What is this?
Mama, how do you enjoy that?
I mean...
Try with the sauce.
I don't want to double dip your sauce. What kind of sauce is this?
Try it, let me know.
Is it one of your crazy sauces? What are you doing there, Goga? You're acting really suspicious. While he's going there, I'm gonna try. Cheers, everybody. It's a sweet sauce.
I apologize for that, everybody. Mama, you went in with the sauce?
Yeah.
How do you like it?
The sauce covers the whole flavor of the calamari.
So you're saying that with the sauce is better?
With the sauce, yeah. I mean, I don't taste anything else besides the sauce.
Okay. Now here's the big question. Did you enjoy that calamari?
That's not calamari. That is not calamari.
Yes, you're right. It is not calamari. Today we got mystery meat, number 4, Mama. Huh? Can you guess what that is?
I cannot guess what this is. I'll go back for more.
No, so it's not as bad as it was for me.
No.
I think what happens for me is that I prepared it. Mm-hmm. When you prepare something, all the smells, all the different experiences because you see it raw, you know, I have that in my head.
Oh my God.
I have that in my head,
you're
Mama.
You're scaring me. Mama. You're scaring me.
So, you know, for me, at least, I can't, everybody. It's not, I'm sorry to everybody that enjoys this, but it's just not for me. Do you enjoy it, Mama?
It's edible.
Yeah.
I've eaten worse things.
Oh, there you go, everybody.
You fed me worse things.
I did. Before I tell you what it is, I want to know how it tasted in lomo saltado with a little bit of steak and tomatoes, and then I'll tell you what it is. You ready?
There's some things over here that look like mush. That does not look appealing at all.
You got to eat that one, Mama. That's what the mystery meat is all about. Tell us, Mama, how does that one taste? I'm really curious.
Oh,
not for you, Omar.
Oh my God.
Wow. The smell really got to me as well. I'm curious.
Wow, like, I want to go back and smell it again so I can describe it, but I don't know if I have the guts to do it.
Wow, wow. It is quite a unique experience,
it stinks.
Everybody. It stinks. I was trying to be polite. It smells very, very strange, doesn't it?
It smells very strange.
I actually, you don't want to try it? Come on, Mamao. We tried everything in this channel. Are you ready? I'm excited for you.
You're excited for me?
I'm rooting for you,
Mamao. How nice of you.
You can do it, Mamao.
The things I do for you, guys.
Go for it, Mamao. Let us know. All
right, cheers to your health.
How is the... Oh, boy. I was gonna say, how is the texture?
It's soft, but I'm chewing it and it's not breaking apart very easily.
So it springs and it comes right back together.
Yeah, kind of like that. The smell is terrible. The taste is not like a filet steak, filet flavor. But it tastes beefy.
I think it's because I mixed it around with a little bit of steak.
Okay.
So maybe you got that juiciness of the steak.
Yeah, I just got a green onion right now, and all my mouth tastes is the green onion. So I guess it doesn't have a lot of flavor.
So let me show you what it is, Mama. Check it out. Mama, what happened? Mama, are you okay? Take a look, Mama. Isn't it interesting? Do you know what it is just by looking at it? Oh boy. Do you know what it is?
Do I need to know?
Yes, you need to know. Okay. Mama, it's tripe. AKA the cow stomach. Yes? Yeah. I will tell you this. I had it in Vietnamese restaurant where they put it in pho. And you had it as well.
Yeah.
But it's not like that. And
it's not like that.
If you are going to have it, I definitely recommend having it in pho. It's better. I'll make you a picanha to make you feel better, Amal. Yes? Yes? Okay. Anyway, guys, these are the results. I hope you guys enjoyed this mystery meat episode. If you do enjoy, make sure you give it a thumbs up. If you're not a subscriber, be sure to subscribe for future videos. Remember, if you are interested in anything I use, everything is always in the description down below. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you guys on the next one. Let me know which mystery meat you want us to cook next, because Mamao is really looking forward to it, right?